Let me check I am online or not.
So guys,
so fine, I am online. Lastly, after 2 or 3 tries, I managed everything to come online. So let me discuss something more about Raspberry Pi. Okay, so today in this live sessions I am clearly discussed about Raspberry Pi. So as I want to make it raw footage so that you can clearly get the knowledge without any fancy stuff. Okay, so first of all, what we learn today, we will learn is what is the necessary things to make a step forward in the Raspberry Pi ecosystem. Basically, in the previous video I discussed how to set up a Raspberry Pi properly in using a Windows system. Okay, so now as I have a Mac system, so further videos are suited from the Mac itself, because it is I like the environment of the Mac, that's the first thing, and it is very user friendly. So let's dig into deeper on this video. So for this journey of this Raspberry Pi tutorial series, I basically use my Raspberry Pi 3 model B version, as this is the most updated and powerful Raspberry Pi available to me. You can apply the same thing for the Raspberry Pi 3 or Raspberry Pi 2 or any other Raspberry Pi versions, like as Raspberry Pi 0 W. Everything is same. And at the time I shooting this video, there is a new operating system come up, which is called Raspbian Brewster or something like that. So take a glance on that. So already a new board is come up, which is a Raspberry Pi 4, and to handle the memory chip of memory capability or the processing capability of that, Raspberry Pi Foundation is updating his operating system. Basically, previously they use this Raspbian OS, that is called Jesse or something like that, and now it's called Brewster. Basically, the kernel is quite improved in this system. The Debian 9 is used in this Raspbian version. So feel free to try that out. As I have the Jesse version, so I will continue with the Jesse versions. So basically, what is the first thing you need to know about Raspberry Pi? Okay, so as Raspberry Pi has a very limited storage space and processing power, so the developer choose the developer choose the Linux environment. Okay, as the Linux have variety of advantages over Windows, so the developer choose the Linux version, and as it is a open source software, so this is a main point for choosing the Linux, is it is an open source operating system. Okay, so anybody can do what they want with this open source kernel. So what are the advantages of Linux operating system? This is the one topic which I covered today. Second topic, what are the basic commands you should know to work with the Linux environment? Okay, so the commands are very simple and user understandable, and the tasks are performed by the commands are very simple, and we use the commands very often in our Raspberry Pi series. So it's better to have a dedicated and separate video for that purpose. Okay, so let's start the video. Now I am logged in with my VNC viewer to my Raspberry Pi desktop, and now I can perform the same thing as I have a physical monitor or anything like that. So there's no different with that. The first point to choose a Linux operating system, what is the advantage? So the first point is it's a multi-user operating system. So how you know that it is a multi-user operating system? Let me say, first of all, you can see that you can use a Raspberry Pi from a variety of places. Okay, I am launching the VNC viewer, and through the VNC viewer I am accessing the tied VNC servers, and you can launch two or three tied VNC servers on a single Raspberry Pi, and all of them are streaming the live desktop in various machines. Okay, let me take a first example is let's see this board. It has a HDMI port on it. Okay, so you can directly plug this HDMI port in your desktop and your display and try to use the Raspberry Pi. And if at the same time if you try to logged in with a tight VNC server or anything VNC server, any VNC server you have, then you can do that on the same time. So if I use the desktop or the display for my purpose and I gave the login panel or login details to another person, we both can use the Raspberry Pi at the same time. So it satisfied the first feature of the Linux environment is multi-user. Okay, so next thing is multitasking. You all know the Linux is a very famous multitasking operating system, and I don't think that I should explain what is multitasking. Okay, I assume that you all know about it. The second thing is security. Obviously, in compared to Windows, the Linux is more secured version of operating system, and it is the most stable version of operating system if you have any small computer. Okay, small means in the sense of that you don't have a huge amount of memory or processing power like Raspberry Pi or the BeagleBone or any other single board computers. And the last and the most important thing is the portability or the convenience to choose to use the Linux with various type of hardwares. Okay, as the Linux environment is free from any type of hardware burdens, so you can use this Linux kernel in any kind of hardwares. Okay, like a BeagleBone or the Raspberry Pi itself or anything like that, like Banana Pi or anything like that. So these are the features of a Linux operating system and why we choose Linux for this purpose, to serve the Raspberry Pi or to make the Raspberry Pi user friendly, to give a user interface for the Raspberry Pi. So it's clear why we choose the Raspberry Pi. Next step, what are the basic commands in the Raspberry Pi environment? Okay, so as you can see, the Raspberry Pi is totally using the Linux kernel or the Linux distribution, which is the Debian distribution, for its day-to-day tasks. So basically we do all the command related tasks or all the command line interfacing tasks using the terminal. So from here you can launch the terminal for your Raspberry Pi. So let me explain the things. First, you can see after launching your terminal, so this name, the Pi, this is a username for your Raspberry Pi. Okay, this is the user ID, which user is using this Raspberry Pi, or there is another command to that to show that. Okay, so here you can see this is the username. Who command is the Linux command which shows you the username. Okay, let me increase the font size. Okay, I think this is much more better than previous one. So the who command says who I am. Means I am which user, or what is my username while I am using the Linux environment. Okay, so the Pi is my username. Next, the very useful command is pwd. Okay, this shows the present working directory. What is the present working directory? Present working directory is a directory, or in the Windows, terms, this is the folder in which I am working. Okay, so when you using the CMD for Windows, you are using the C drive. Okay, for your every tasks, you can switch the drive and you can switch the folders in which you want to perform some tasks. So for the after booting as a Pi user, I am in the in this directory under slash. There is a home directory, and in the inside the home directory there is a directory called Pi. So I am currently working on this Pi directory for my every task which I perform is applicable in this directory only as of now. Okay, so let me share you something. So this is the working directories structure or the file structure of a Linux environment. Okay, so you can go through this website where I where I have this photo, and the guys do a very good good job while designing this this image. Okay, this is a very simple and useful image for the beginners. Okay, so the all the things suppose this the slash is a container, okay, where you we put all the stuffs of a Linux operating system. So in this slash folder there is this much of folders are there. Okay, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 and 10, the 10 main folders are there, or the 10 main directory are present in this slash directory. Okay, so the root directory and the boot directory, the bin directory, the sub bin directory, the user var dev etc opt media. To know more about these directories, you go through this website and you have a great knowledge about all these directories as the main task for this video is to know the basics about Linux environment. So I don't go much deeper as the it affects the length of the video. Okay, so in the home directory we are working on the home directory. Basically this is the home for all the users. Okay, so when a users log into the system or a Linux system, he basically have a directory. Okay, he basically have a directory with his username, and inside that we can perform all the tasks for our Linux environment or for our Raspberry Pi environment. So let's see more more programs. Okay, so there is a very useful program, and that is so basically this there is a command. So the clear command works to clean up our terminal. Okay, so it don't give a don't clean up the command. It basically puts some white spaces or some in various Linux environment it perform different tasks. In the Raspberry Pi it basically puts the last line or the last execution line in the top of the UI so that it looks clear to the user. Okay, and the next task is ls. So what does the ls perform? Ls shows us the list of files or the directories present in the directory from where we are working. Okay, so I am currently working in pwd. So as you can see, this is the my current directory, and inside this directory I have this much of directories present. So the desktop directory is shows that contains the desktop items, the document contains the document, and the download magpie music and picture, this the name are suggested what they contains. Okay, so these are the basic folders you have in this directory. Basically this file is not present in your case. Basically one of my projects creates this file for in this directory. Let's see the next command. So the next command is mkdir. Okay, mkdir, the full form of this command is make directory. You know what it means by make directory phrase. Okay, the make directory means you create a directory. Okay, so you create a directory in the directory where you are currently present. Okay, so to perform that task, to create a directory, you have to perform a command which is mkdir. Okay, so after that you have to put the directory name. Okay, so I put the directory name as okay, if the if after pressing the enter there is no error messages, that means the command is executed properly. So now if we see or if we rerun the command, that is ls, you can see a new directory called dny is created properly. Okay, so we properly created one directory and we know how we can see all the directory present in the current working directory. Let's go to the dny directory. Let's go inside the dny directory. Okay, to perform that task there is a command called cd, which means change directory, and after that dny the directory name and press enter. You can see that this changes. Okay, previously we are in our home directory, which is denoted by this tilde sign, and after we press the command cd dny, it changes our current working directory to dny. Okay, so let's confirm it. Pwd, you know what it means. So after that you can see that previously we are in the py directory, now we are in dny directory, so the cd command is worked properly. So what is the next command? Suppose you have a system, you know how to search all the files present in the directory, and you know how to change the directory, you know how to create the directory. What's the next task? The next task is how to create a new file in that directory. Okay, so to perform that task, there is a various way to perform that task. The two or three commands are there. Vi, you can use the vi editor, which is a text editor. For this task you can use the touch functions to create a folder, to create a file easily. And the third, and which we use, is the nano program. Okay, the nano is same like a vi editor, but it's I love this command. That's the reason I use this. You can feel free to use the vi editor for your tasks. So to use or to create a new file, you have to put some command. Okay, and this is not a single phrase command. The command starts with sudo. Sudo means super user do. Okay, so you give a message to the Raspberry Pi or the Raspbian operating system that you are try to use the super user privileges. Okay, so you are the you are pretending to be the super user for the system and you are performing some task over it. So the sudo commands make you a super user for this, the command you put after this sudo command. Okay, so after that you simply write nano. Okay, this is the command itself to create a file. Okay, and after that the file name, you can put anything. Okay, like this I put a name example. Okay, and after that I create a text file. Okay, so to create a text file you just need to save, or to you need to give the name with .txt extension. Okay, so as soon as you press enter, you can see you are head towards a editor like task, an editor like thing where you can type anything you want, like your notepad. Okay, it's very simple, it has very simple interface, but it has some difficulty. Okay, so let's type something. So I type this much of data, which is a random data, don't try to find any meaning of this string. Okay, so to how to save the file. Okay, to save the file you have to press the command and X at the same time, and after that you have to press Y to save the data, and after that you ensure the file name. After inserting the file name, press the enter, and damn, you are created successfully a file. Okay, so how to see what are the file present, is the file is created or not? So for that I use ls command, and you can see there is a file called example which is listed inside the dny folder. Okay, so let's see what's inside ls, sorry, what inside the example.txt. So to see that, you have to give this command, and you can see the data you put inside the example.txt file is present in this inside this file. So you can see that the file is created properly, and to exit or to back, you simply press the control and X button at the same time, and you can see the glorious terminal window again. So let's try something new or some other commands. So till now we see how we can create some command, how we can create some directory, how we can create some folder. Okay, so how we can come out of the folder. Okay, so previously I am in the tilde sign, means I am in the home folder for the Pi user, and after that I press the command, I enter the command cd dny, which bring me inside the dny directories. So now I complete my task of creating a file. Now I wanted to go back to my home directory. How we can do that? So we can do this task in several way. I am performing that. So cd, and after that enter two dots, and it brings you back to the home directory. Let's check it, and you can see we are back in the home directory of the Pi user. Okay, so what the cd double dot means? So cd double creates, you can say it cd double creates or cd double dot or cd dot dot dot, anything like that, what you are comfortable with. So the cd double dot is a command to, it brings you back, okay, to the parent directory. Means while I am going inside the dny directory, I am going into my child directory, and while I am typing or executing the command cd double dot, I am coming back from that directory. Okay, so after performing this, I have some situations where I have to delete the directory which I create previously, the dny directory. Don't try to delete any of the system or pre-created directory or the system, any of the system directory, because it may happen that that brings some cost to you, or you just need to restore or reformat your SD card, as it may perform any corruption on the device. I don't know what file you are going to delete, so I can't say that properly. So let me explain how to delete the any file or any folder. Okay, for that there is a command called rm. Okay, rm means remove. Okay, remove, and after that dash r. So what it performs, it removes the directory along with the file which it have. If you enter the rm command only, you can only delete the blank directories, but when you are entering a command rm dash r, you can delete a directory though it have some file in it or not. Okay, so dny, this is the directory. Okay, so let me delete it. So you can see it asks me why, if I really want to delete it or not. I simply reply it with why, and you can see that the file is deleted. And to ensure that you don't find the dny folder or dny directory again, as it is permanently deleted from your system. So let me perform some more tasks. Basically you have to create some Python programs, okay, in the Raspberry Pi. Okay, as Python is the main programming language used to develop some programs for the Raspberry Pi, so you have to create some Python file, but you don't know how to create any Python file in Linux environment using the terminal. So let me show you how you can do that. So for that purpose, I again create a directory. So do this things twice or thrice, and The practice make you perfect in the Linux environment, okay? In any field of your life, the practice makes you perfect. Okay, so I again enter the command mkdir and again a file for directory name, but this time I enter some different name which suits the purpose which I perform in this directory. So you can see there is no error message. So there is a directory we created. Now we just go inside the directory. One bonus thing is after cd, if you type two or three letters of your directory, desired directory, and after that you simply press the tab button, the Linux terminal type the whole name of the folder for you or the directory for you. So now you can see I am in the Python code directory, and let me clear up the thing. So I clear up all the previous tasks data. So now let me try to create some codes, okay, for simple Python things, okay. You can see the Python, you can refer to the Python video series I previously made in my channel. There's two or three videos, or I think four or five videos, and that's enough for your simple tasks in the Raspberry Pi. Like every Python program which we write for our Raspberry Pi contains some basic things like print, the event management things like if else, or the looping things, and the final thing is the threads and all that, which I will make some video for the thread concepts, so that you can properly use the thread concepts in your Python script. And basically threads give you more flexibility in your Python script, okay. That's the out of the topic of this video. So let me explain what I try to do right now. Basically I try to create some programs, or I try to create a program, simple program for the Python. So basically the glorious Hello World program, okay. So you all know about the Hello World program, but at this time I simply write the Hello World program using the terminal. So to create a new file, the file can be anything. So to create a new file, there is a command called sudo nano, and after that the file name, which is obviously Hello World. And at this time I save the file with the py extension, which is the extension for the Python file, okay. So after entering that, you again see the notepad like stuffs, but it is in the terminal, not in a GUI, okay. So it looks cool, quite different, quite time, and I really enjoy the Python environment. Don't know why, but I enjoy it. So the simple, you can see that if we use a nano to write anything or any program, you can see the colored things which generally applies in various IDEs. So this nano program also have this kind of features. So a simple program, so this is the program which I made, very complex rocket science program, you can say. So let me save it. So I am saving it by the same process, control X, after that press Y for yes to give the yes, and after that press enter to save it. So let me check if the file is properly created or not. Yes, the file is properly created. Now we are going to execute the Python program using our terminal. So for that there is a command called Python, and after that you can simply enter the name of the file. So this is the name of my file python. This is the whole command, which is python, and after that the file name. Okay, and as soon as I press enter, you can see my code is properly working and running. So good job guys. If you have the same thing in your display, then you are ready to go further for your Python projects or to work with Raspberry Pi using your terminal itself. Here let me give you some bonus things, which is some very useful command for your Raspberry Pi. This is a command called pinout, which is very useful for your developing tasks while you are developing a hardware for your Raspberry Pi and don't have the proper internet connection or anything like that. You just enter the command and press enter, and a graphical view of your pinout is displayed on your terminal. Okay, so this is ASCII value, basically ASCII value format, and this is the whole pinout of your Raspberry Pi. You can execute this command at any time, and basically it performs well, and it gives you every time gives you the pinout of the Raspberry Pi, and here it shows what is the proper number starting and where the proper number ending, and all some different hardware things. So that's it for this video guys. I try a new thing I try the live video of YouTube for the first time. So if you guys like this video till now, and if you guys enjoyed this video, then please press the like button, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. And if you have any help from this video, or if you find that this video is useful, then please click the like button and also the subscribe button, and feel free to comment any of your thoughts about this video. So have a good night.